Hello everyone. Today in this session, second session of web programming, we'll be learning about the concept of World Wide Web. Okay, that is nothing but www, whatever you write, the short form, that is www, it means what? World Wide Web. According to this term, it's nothing but all over the world, when you are said to be accessing the information, whenever you are said to be getting the information from the internet, it is through the help of the World Wide Web you are said to be accessing the information. You are not accessing the internet, but you are accessing the information over the internet. Okay, that is said to be your World Wide Web. Okay, so today in this session, you will be learning about what is a World Wide Web. Then you will be learning about the history of World Wide Web, structure of www, then you have the components of www, then fundamentals of www, then how it works, your web, the difference between internet and www, 3D map of www, and web 2.0, so 2.0. so what and all these terms mean, that you will be learning in this session. Okay, so let's check out one by one. So first term, what do you mean by a World Wide Web? You all know already, what is internet? Internet is nothing but a communication or a set of systems are said to be getting connected to each other. It's not set. It's million number of systems are getting connected to each other. That is said to be internet. And whereas the World Wide Web, it is a part of your internet. Okay, it's part of internet. It's nothing but it's a content which is being considered in the internet. So that content, it may be in the format of HTML. It's a language, you can say hypertext markup language, which is used to design the multiple pages where number of HTML files are being linked to one another. Multiple HTML pages are linked from one end to another end. Okay, the aspect of HTML is to exchange the information between the computers. Mainly this World Wide Web, it will help you out to exchange the information over the internet. And the document which you are said to be accessing each and every time over the World Wide Web, it is called as the web page. Okay, and how you are said to be accessing? It is through the URL which you are said to be giving. So example, www.google.com. When you access that, actually behind it, an HTML code, it will be written. That HTML code, it will be linking from one file to another file. That is said to be a part of your World Wide Web. Okay, remember, this is the World Wide. Okay, so next, you will be learning about the history of the www. It was said to be introduced by Tim Berners-Lee. He invented this www in 1989 till 1990. It was said to be existing. Afterwards, he moved on to a www consortium, which was introducing, like, it was able to draw multiple standards. Multiple, like, whenever you are said to be introducing, it will be in the beginning in a different way. When a software or anything it is being introduced, it will be in the format which is said to be a domain which is helpful for certain aspects you will be using for the public. Afterwards, how do you do is you maintain your own standards, and through that standards you are said to be fetching the information over the internet. Okay, that every time the changes happen. So in the beginning, in 1993, that is 30th April, it was said to be in the CERN's World Wide Web. It was said to be introduced. It was licensed, it an open license where it was said to be available for everybody. Afterwards, in 1994, the www consortium came into effect, where it was devoted to certain sites only which are said to be available public. Otherwise, it is said to be, like, you can say paid ones. When you are said to be accessing the website, you have to register, you have to use, then you have to access. That was the part of your www. Okay, next, this mainly the history of your www, it is said to be mainly involved for the purpose of sharing the information. Okay, so next, when you consider the structure of your www, it consists of a client, it consists of web pages, servers, the browsers, and the networking protocols it will be having. So client is nothing but the user who is said to be accessing the information through the help of a browser. I may be using Chrome, I may be using Mozilla, or I may be using any other Opera operating system. Those are said to be your nothing but your browsers which are being used to access the various pages. So in that pages, you have the those pages are nothing but the HTML content which we have already discussed. The web pages consist of the HTML content. Okay, and the servers are nothing but where your web pages are set to be placed. Is nothing but onto the servers it will be placed. From each and every time it will be fetched from the server. You can say a web server will be there from which you are set to be accessing the pages, and your browser, it will be using the various aspects of HTML where you want to have the information. It may be in different formats. It may be a graphic one, it may be textual data, it may be related to a sound data. All those are said to be present in the web server. Mainly the client, he requests and he is said to be getting through the help of the server. And how do you get connected? It is through the help of the transmission control protocols. Nothing but the rules and regulations which are being followed while the information is being transmitted. Okay. So this is the part of your structure. So the components which are there in the World Wide Web, as you have discussed, like the client or the browser is there. Then you have the servers which will help you out in getting the web pages. Then you have the cache, like temporarily you are said to be storing the information or storing the web pages onto the cache, or you can say cache, okay, where the web pages are said to be stored temporarily. That is said to be a cache. Okay, and internet is nothing but multiple connections of different networks and the computers. Okay, and the various semantic components, nothing but when I am designing a web page, you need all these things. One is your HTTP, then you need HTML, then you have extensible markup language, then the uniform resource identifiers, you need it. Okay, so all these are said to be a part of your World Wide Web. The fundamentals, your hypertext is nothing but it's a language which will, hypertext is nothing but when I want to link from one end to another end, one page to another page, one text to another text, you use the term hypertext. You have already learned about hyperlink. So hyperlink, you link from one file to another file. Same way here also, hypertext, one text, it will be linking to the another part. So when you give an information onto a Google, you write something. So whatever content you are said to be writing, on those based contents, it links to that particular web page. That is said to be called as a hypertext. And hypermedia, okay, when you are said to be saying the term hypermedia, media, it will be representing a link which goes to a certain, like, audio file, it may be a video file. When you are accessing something, it moves to the other part of it. That is called as hypermedia. Okay, then you have the web browsers. As I said, those are said to be the softwares which will help you out to access the various web pages over the internet. And how do you get linked? It is through the HTML or the XML. Then you have the web servers. Web servers are said to be nothing but the servers on which the various informations are being stored or the pages are being stored, and those are being retrieved by the client when they are said to be accessing the information. Okay, and next you will be learning about the uniform resource locators, are nothing but the addresses which you are giving when you are said to be accessing the files. I give address through which I am accessing certain thing. For example, www.gmail.com, www.google.com or any other yahoo.com. All those are nothing but your URLs when you are said to be specifying, which identifies and places your web pages on the screen. Okay. And how the web works is, it is nothing but in this internet you have the web. So how do you access is all the information, the server, it gets through the internet, and those are said to be got from the HTML files which are being created over the one of the server pages. Okay, and here you have multiple systems. Those systems, it may be getting connected through a broadband connection, and those systems may be having different types of browsers. Those browsers, this one system, another system, another system, another system, they may be maintaining different types of browsers. So each browser may access the internet, and that internet consists of the various web pages which are being fetched and stored in the server. Okay, so this is how the web works. Okay. The difference between the internet and World Wide Web, already you may be knowing it, but some part you can say both are not said to be like, they are said to be meaning which is said to be different one. Internet is nothing but a network of network is said to be your internet, where multiple computers, millions of systems are being connected. Whereas World Wide Web is nothing but it's a medium which is used to access the internet. Okay, web is nothing but it's a medium to access the internet. Web is just a portion of internet. It's a part of internet which is said to be web. It is nothing but it's creation of web pages which will be stored on the server. From the server you are said to be fetching the files and displaying over the internet. Okay, so you remember the web is the part of the internet. So both are said to be having the difference. So this is an image which gives the like 3D effect of how the internet is being connected to multiple systems at different ends. Okay, you can check out with the things, like you can see there may be a different kinds of network, different lines which are being getting connected. It may be a wired or the wireless connections. Okay, and another part is there in the web, that is your web 2.0. So mainly the web consists of all the combination of HTML files through which you are said to be getting connected from one page to another page online. But here web 2.0 is nothing but it's an aspect where it provides a platform with different types of tools, higher end tools which will help you out in getting communicated easily. For example, the social networking websites, it may be a Facebook, Twitter and all. Those comes under the web 2, the second generation. So second generation, it will said to be helping out in social networking. The third generation, it may be having different changes, but web 2 is nothing but the second generation, where you have the social network, music and video websites which are being fetched. Those are interactive websites. Those comes under the web 2.0, and you are said to be accessing the like images over the websites, that is also web 2.0, and blogging. You prepare the blogs, you put it onto the net, that is said to be coming under the web 2.0, where everybody is said to be accessing through the help of the YouTube, the blogs which are being created. Okay, this is a part of the web 2.0. So today in this session we have learned like various aspects of World Wide Web and the difference between the World Wide Web and the internet. So these are the basic terms which you have to learn and which you have to know in your future sessions, so that you are said to be rectified with some of the terms. You will be knowing with the some of the terms when you are said to be discussing, when we are said to be discussing. Okay, so today this session I will be ending with this one. You have learned about the World Wide Web. Okay, thank you.